particular to Good afternoon, everyone. Am I audible? Am I audible to you all? Yes. Let's see. We were discussing the last part of plant growth regulators, okay? And that was vernalization. That was vernalization, yes or no? What was vernalization? For flowering, there are many plants which has to be subjected to low temperature, and that process is known as vernalization. I have told you, plant having certain factors, they are actually genes only. Okay, there are certain factors which is going to inhibit the flowering, but low temperature inactivate that factor. In that case, a factor which is inhibiting the flower, you can say flowering, if that will be inhibited, in that case, you can say flowering will take place. Yes or no? And what was the significance of vernalization? It gives time for somatic growth before plant bears a fruit, you can say fruit. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So if you will talk about that, okay. What was the part of the plant that is going to perceive the photoperiod? Which part of the plant have ability to perceive the photoperiod?
So the leaf.
Leaves. But here, you can say, let's see, the stimulus is perceived by the mature stem apex or by the embryo of the seeds, but not by the leaves. So in this way, it is slightly different. Getting my point? In this way, this is slightly different from the photoperiodism. Yes or no? Yes or no? Vernalization can be seen in many. I will talk about vernalization. Vernalization is seen in many winter annuals and biennial plants. Do you people know annual and biennial? Any doubt in that?
No, sir.
Agreed, everyone? No issues in that? I will talk about winter annuals. Any plant that you people remember in that case? Tell me. I'm going to talk about winter annuals over here. Actually, if you will see, it is going to have two varieties. How many varieties are there? One is winter variety. Another is a spring variety. They are going to ask you people. No issues. A spring variety is planted in a spring season. Yes or no? No issues? Any doubt? And winter variety is going to be planted during the winters. Now, if I will talk about biennial plant, in that many plants are there like sugar beet, cabbage, carrot. No issue? They are going to die in the second season. Just remember few names and the basic thing about the vernalization in this case. No issues? This part is there to be understood. Okay. And then read out NCERT properly. You are not going to face any problem in this. The only one thing that like, you can say wheat is there. Wheat is there. You may have heard this thing that this year cold is not proper, so wheat, you can say wheat crop is not going to be as good as in earlier years. Have you people heard about this? That due to lack of low temperature, wheat crop is not proper?
No, sir.
No issues. If winters will not be there, proper flowering will not take place because the wheat crop needs vernalization. Agreed? You people read this thing? Have you people solved the assignment that I have sent to you people? What is the next chapter in your book? Remember it?
Sir, digestive system.
Digestive system. Let's see. This topic is there to be understood. One of the most logical, you can say, section that is there in 11th class is animal physiology. Is animal physiology. Do you people know what is physiology? Do you people know what is physiology? Everyone, please participate a bit. Do you people know what is physiology?
Yes, sir.
What's that?
The study of the functioning of our body.
It is the study of mechanism by which your body is going to function normally. Normally means how a food is going to be digested in your body. Okay. How you are, you can say your respiratory system is working. How your circulatory system is working. All of them are going to fall under what? Physiology. Agreed? One is anatomy. And another word is pathology. You keep on hearing this thing, na? Dr. Lal Path Lab and all. Dr. Lal Path Lab and all. Or any other like SRL diagnostic lab, because Path Lab, that kind of thing you people may have seen. Path Lab means pathology. How disease is taking place, that is going to fall under pathology. We are going to read human physiology. Your screen is visible now?
Yes, sir.
Human physiology means we are going to see how human systems are going to perform normally. Under that, we are going to read digestive system first. We are going to read digestive system first. And what's that? Digestion and absorption is the name of the topic. What do you people eat? You eat carbohydrate, lipid, protein, and nucleic acid. You eat carbohydrate, lipid, protein, and nucleic acid. Agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? Carbohydrate, in carbohydrate, polysaccharide is there. Can you name some of the polysaccharide that is present in your food? Anyone? Can you name some of the polysaccharide present in your food? Tell me, dear. Have you heard about a starch?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Have you heard about a starch? That is a polysaccharide. You are going to eat lipid, protein, and nucleic acid. Can you imagine how it is going to go into your blood? Can you imagine that? Can you imagine? Tell me, dear. A starch is not there in your blood, no? Glucose is there in your blood. Agreed? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
A starch is not there in your blood, rather glucose is there. So, what is the process of conversion of a starch into glucose is known as? Tell me, have you people read biomolecule? Tell me, dear, have you read this?
Yes, sir.
Yes. How the bond was getting formed? How the bond was getting formed? How the bond was getting formed? Tell me.
Glycosidic bonds.
Dehydration was the process. In every bond, you people may have seen that one H2O molecule is getting removed. Yes or no? One H2O molecule was getting removed. Yes or no? In all the bonds, like in protein, peptide bond was formed. Do you people remember how peptide bond was formed? How it happened? Tell me, dear. How it happened? It happened by a process dehydration, that is removal of what? H2O molecule. Agreed? Isn't it? Is it like that? Is it like that? You people forgot biomolecule. No issues. I am telling you, all the bond was formed by removal of H2O. Bond was formed. So what do you people think? How the bond are going to be broken? By the process known as hydrolysis. What? Hydrolysis. What is hydrolysis? It is the breaking down of bond due to addition of water molecule. Agreed, everyone? Have you people read classification of enzymes? One group of enzyme was hydrolase. Tell me, dear. Have you heard about this class of enzyme? All the digestive enzyme digestive belong to this class only. Hydrolase are the enzymes that is going to bring about hydrolysis. Hydrolase are the enzymes that are going to bring about hydrolysis. Yes or no? You people are not saying anything. Are you able to? Yes, Shraddha, what is, you got it, na?
Yes, I got it.
Everyone? So see, now we are going to define digestion first. It is the breaking down of complex food substances into simple absorbable form. It is breaking down of complex food substances into simple absorbable form. Agreed? How it is going to happen? By two things. One is mechanical and one is biochemical. What do you people understand by mechanical thing? What is mechanical?
So non-enzymatic breakdown.
Yes. You are going to crush the food by the help of teeth and gastric rugae. That is going to fall under mechanical digestion. And what is biochemical process? It is by action of enzymes. Yes or no? Action of enzyme. Bio because living, chemical because of enzymes. So digestion is a mechanical or chemical or both process.
So both.
Agreed? If you will talk about your food is going to contain two things. One, that is going to provide you with energy. One, that is going to provide you with energy. And one, that will not provide energy, but it is, you can say, essential for immunity and all, for normal functioning of the body. The food that is going to provide you with energy is known as macronutrients or proximate principle. And the food that is going to help you to only protect yourself from any disease is known as micronutrient or protective principle of your food. So how many types of components are there in your food? One is proximate principle and another is? One is protective principle. Yes or no, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Everyone? No issues in that? Now I will talk about minerals. Minerals, if some mineral is required in an amount in excess of 100 mg per day, this is known as macro element. And if it is required in a very less amount, it is a micronutrient, iron, iodine, zinc, sodium, potassium, calcium, and chloride. They are there. Yes or no? What do you think? If I will say the process of digestion is carried out by digestive system, what will you say? Is it true or not?
Yes, sir. So can you show the minerals part again?
Done. I will talk about, you can say, the process of digestion is carried out by your digestive system. Digestive system having alimentary canal and digestive gland. Digestive system having alimentary canal and digestive gland. Yes or no? alimentary canal and digestive gland. Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Alimentary canal having following things. Now, let's see. This is going to be your oral cavity. Okay. Lots of things are written, so I'm going to remove few things first. You see, this is your oral cavity. You are taking food from here. Food is coming over here. Now, everyone, this is the bolus. This is the bolus. Means you are chewed the food, and now this is your bolus. That part, after chewing, saliva mixed food is known as bolus. Now, if you will go behind, in your oral cavity, you can see clearly a structure like this. A structure like this. This structure is going to be known as uvula. What? Uvula. Yes or no? You can see there is a small structure hanging in your mouth if you will open it up. Yes or no? This is known as uvula. Everyone, you see, we are going to take food from here. Sorry, food from here, and we are going to take air from here. Yes or no? Air from here, food from here. Here, the internal layers are there. What? Internal layers are there. What do you people think? What is the function of uvula? What do you people think? What is the function of uvula? Tell me, dear. Shreyas.
Oh, yes, sir.
Okay. What do you think? What should be the function of uvula?
So it stimulates the gag reflex in case anything that's not supposed to go in goes in the mouth.
The thing is there, its primary function is to try to understand. If this is going to push it, it will come and will cover this area. It will not let the food go inside this. Yes or no? It will go behind and will cover this area. It will not let the food go like this. Yes or no? Because this is an open space only. Food can go over here also. Agreed? So, uvula closes internal layers while swallowing. Swallowing. Yes or no? Agreed, everyone? Every time it is not going to stimulate the gag reflex. Yes or no? And for gag reflex, uvula is not necessary at all. If you will touch the posterior part of the soft palate or initial part of the pharynx, it will be initiated. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. You people understood? Try to understand my point. Everyone, air is going to go through this and coming like this. This is an open area. This is nasal chamber. Food is going to go through this and will try to go back. In that, it will push the uvula and uvula is going to cover this area. Yes or no? Everyone, are you people getting or not?
Yes, sir.
Agreed, everyone? This is there. Now you see, food will come over here. The area behind the internal layers is known as nasopharynx, and the area behind the oral cavity is known as oropharynx. Everyone agrees to this? Tell me, dear.
Yes, sir.
Nasopharynx and oropharynx together, they are going to be known as pharynx. And pharynx is a common passage for food and air. Can you people feel this? Tell me, dear.
Yes, sir.
Everyone. Air is coming this way. Food is coming like this. So this area is a common passage for food and air. Agree with this, everyone? Okay, now you see there are two pipes that you people can see. One is this pipe, another is this pipe. One is gray one and one is blue one. What do you people think? What do you people think? Which is trachea, anteriorly placed or posteriorly placed? Anteriorly placed or posteriorly placed? Trachea is anteriorly placed. This is one question. Okay, in your neck, you can say you are able to feel one structure that is known as larynx. I will teach you people in respiratory system. This is larynx. Larynx is kept over trachea only. Agreed, everyone? Any doubt in this? No issues? Which pipe is food? This is esophagus. Esophagus is coming down and going inside or opening inside the stomach. At the junction, what is present? What is present? Gastroesophageal sphincter. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Gastroesophageal sphincter going to guard the opening of esophagus into a stomach. Agree with this? Everyone? No issues? No.
Yes, sir.
This is your stomach. Stomach to going to go to open into duodenum, and at the opening of a stomach into duodenum, there is a sphincter present. This is known as pyloric sphincter. Yes or no? Pyloric sphincter guards opening of a stomach into duodenum. Agreed, everyone?
Yes.
So what is the two part of the stomach?
I am going to tell you. Just give me a minute. Later on I will discuss. You see. Over here I will discuss all the parts. Okay? Not yes, two sir. Parts, rather four parts are there. Getting my point? Now, this is duodenum. Then comes jejunum, and the later part is known as ileum. Duodenum, jejunum, and ileum falls under a small intestine part. Agreed, dear? Agreed? Now, ascending colon, descending transverse colon, and descending colon. Before that, cecum is there. So ileum is going to open into which part of large intestine? Everyone? Ileum is going to open into which part of large intestine? Tell me, dear. Ileum is going to open into which part? Tell me, dear. This is ileum. And it is going to into which part? Going to open into which part?
So the cecum.
Cecum. And the, you can say sphincter or the valve that is present over here is known as ileocecal valve. Okay, this is known as ileocecal valve. It guards opening of ileum into cecum. Yes or no? Can you see a finger-like projection present? Or you can say outgrowth arising from cecum. Can you see that? That is known as vermiform appendix. It is a vestigial organ as far as human is concerned. Yes or no? Everyone, please tell me, dear.
Yes.
Yes, cecum. See over here. Vermiform appendix is there, then ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon. Now you see, can you see here over here? Is a S is forming going to form over here? Can you call it as S-shaped? This area, you can see.
Yes, sir.
Wherever S-shaped structure is there, that is known as sigmoid colon. What? Sigmoid colon. Everyone. So large intestine having cecum, colon, rectum. After rectum, you can see this area is known as anal canal, and this opening is known as anus. Agreed, everyone? So elementary canal of human starts with oral cavity. The anterior opening of oral cavity is known as mouth. What? Mouth. Oral cavity will lead to pharynx. Pharynx will lead to esophagus. Esophagus will lead to stomach. And what is the name of a sphincter present at the junction of, you can say, esophagus and stomach? What is the name of a sphincter present at the junction of esophagus and stomach? What's that?
Gastroesophageal sphincter.
Gastroesophageal sphincter. What is another name of, you can say, for this sphincter?
Sir, not sure.
Cardiac sphincter. Because it is opening in which part of the stomach? In the cardiac part. We will discuss that later on. Don't worry. Now, a stomach will open into which part? Please keep on answering. I'm just asking only. A stomach is going to open into which part?
Sir, duodenum.
Duodenum.
Duodenum. And what is the name of a sphincter that guards that opening?
Pyloric sphincter.
Pyloric sphincter. Yes, very good. Duodenum will lead to jejunum. Jejunum will lead to ileum. Ileum will open into, so a small intestine having three parts, duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. Yes or no? Duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. Now see. This ileum is going to open into which part?
Cecum.
Cecum. Very good. Cecum having a finger-like outgrowth that is known as
vermiform
appendix. Agreed? Cecum will lead to which part?
Ascending colon.
Ascending colon will lead to which part?
Transverse colon.
Transverse colon. Transverse colon will lead to
descending colon.
Descending colon will lead to
sigmoid colon.
Sigmoid colon will lead to
rectum.
Rectum to anal canal and then anus. Yes or no? This is your digestive system. We will start with oral cavity now. Everyone agrees? Oral cavity. Let's see what is there for oral cavity. Its anterior opening is known as mouth. Agreed.
Yes.
It is bound anteriorly by lips, superiorly by palate. Your palate is going to be divided into two parts. One is hard palate, one is soft palate. Hard palate is anterior part. It is bony. Soft palate is posterior part. Bone is not present. That is why it is soft. It can move. Yes or no, everyone? Inferiorly, floor of the mouth is there, and posteriorly, oropharynx is there. This area is oropharynx. This area is oropharynx. So, oral cavity lead to which structure? Oral cavity lead to which structure? Tell me, dear.
So the pharynx.
Now, what all structures are there that you people need to know?
So
about the, yes, tell me, dear.
So can you just show the oral cavity part again?
Yes. Now you can see over here what all structures are there in your oral cavity that you people need to study, okay, at NEET level. Tell me, dear, what all structures are there? I will say there are two structures that is of your use, and those are what? Those are what? One is teeth, another is tongue. That you people need to explain in detail. Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Let's start with teeth. What do you think? Teeth. What all words? There are three words that is given in your book regarding the, you can say, human teeth. Do you people know about them? What are they? They are ecodont, heterodont, and diapiodont. Yes or no, everyone? These kind of words are used, no? Say yes or no. Please say this.
Yes, sir.
Is it there? What is the meaning of being ecodont? What is the meaning of being ecodont? Everyone.
So that the teeth are attached to our skull, like the bone.
See over here. Not exactly. It is similar, but the thing is there. I will say over here, teeth is present in the bony socket. If you will take out the tooth, just see to it. If you will take out the tooth, okay? If you will take out the tooth from the socket, you can say, I am going to extract the tooth now. Okay, everyone? Do you see what I am going to see? You will see there is a bony socket. Okay, you can clearly see this. So a teeth present inside bony socket is known as ecodont. Agreed, everyone? And do you people feel that human having only one type of teeth or many types of teeth, like incisor, like canine, like premolar and molar? What is that? Only one is there, or many types of teeth are there?
So many.
So if more than one type of teeth are there, that condition is known as heterodont. So human teeth is ecodont, heterodont, and diapiodont, because you all have observed this thing that if you will see, you must have observed this thing that there are two sets of teeth that were there in your mouth. One were milk teeth that has fallen already. And one is the permanent teeth that is there in your mouth at this point of time. Yes or no? Everyone? Here.
Yes, sir.
Your teeth is going to be divided into two parts. One is crown, one is root. One is crown and another is root. Agreed? Crown is that white part that is, that you people can see in your mouth. Yes or no? Agreed? And root is inside the bony socket that you cannot see. You can say you people cannot see. Yes or no? See over here. Can you see these things? Can I say they are attaching bone to the tooth? Yes or no? Can I say that? And what is their name? It's periodontal ligament. It's periodontal ligament. Yes or no? Tell me here.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, I am going to read out crown. This blue one part, blue part that you people can see, this is enamel. What? Enamel. The outermost part of the tooth is known as enamel. Yes or no, that white color part. Agreed? This yellow one is known as dentin. Getting my point? So, what is the outermost layer in the crown part? Tell me. What is the outermost layer in the crown part? Are you people not getting it?
So, enamel.
Yes. Anybody having doubt in this? Dear, if you have doubt, you can ask me. No? And below enamel, which part is there? Which layer is there actually? Below enamel, which layer is actually?
So, dentin.
Present? Dentin. This is for crown. What about root? The outermost layer is cementum. What? And below cementum, dentin is there. Agreed? So dentin is there in the crown as well as root. Yes or no? Enamel is there in the crown and cementum is there in the root. Agreed, everyone? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Everyone, you see. Inner two dentin, this red one is known, red structure is known as pulp, is the only living tissue present in the teeth. And it is there in the crown also, and it is there in the root also. Agreed, everyone? Enamel is the hardest substance of your body. What is the hardest substance of your body? It's enamel. Agreed? Everyone, it's enamel. For a yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
And the only living part of the tooth is? The only living part of the tooth is? Pulp. Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, of course. Now, what is periodontal ligament?
So the ligament that attaches the bony socket to the teeth.
Yes, agreed. Now, here, if you will see, enamel is going to be secreted by a particular kind of cell known as ameloblast cell. What? Which cell is going to secrete enamel? Tell me, dear.
Ameloblast cells.
Ameloblast cell. Agreed? And what is the origin of ameloblast cell? It is from ectoderm of the embryo. There are three germ layers now that is getting formed. Ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. You must have read this thing at the time of Animal Kingdom also.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is there? It is ectodermal in origin. No issues in this. Now everyone, what is the cell that is going to secrete dentin? It's odontoblast cell. It is mesodermal in origin. Then, now, one a bit difficult thing that is there. I hope you people will try to understand. Sarpi's fiber. Do you know what is Sarpi's fiber?
No,
see over here. This is periodontal ligament. What is the function of periodontal ligament? Tell me that first. Please repeat. Periodontal ligament.
Sir, attaches the cementum to the bone.
You see, some part of periodontal ligament is, you can say, embedded inside cementum. It is entering cementum. Yes or no? This part is known as Sarpi's fiber. Yes or no? If you will take out the section of cementum and you will read that under microscope, part of periodontal ligament present inside cementum. What should be its role? Its role should be there in the attachment only. Agreed? Agreed?
Yes, sir.
If you people will take out the tooth, you will see there is an opening at the apex of the tooth. Apex, known as apical foramen. What is there? Apical foramen. All the blood vessel, nerves, and everything goes inside the tooth through this apical foramen only. It is wide in young tooth, but in permanent teeth, it becomes narrow progressively. Somebody will ask you, through which part nerve and blood to tooth enters the tooth? What will you say? Apical foramen.
Apical foramen.
Agreed? Do you people have any issue in this diagram? Please observe. It is important diagram.
So, could you give us a couple of minutes to label this diagram?
Yes, you can take. Done? Everyone?
Just a minute, sir. We're copying the diagram.
No issues. Copy. done.
So just a minute, the labelings.
No issues. Level it. Done.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Let's see. What about human dentition? Let's see. Important thing is there. Human dentition having two sets of teeth. Two sets. One is primary teeth. Another is permanent teeth. See over here. In primary teeth, we have central incisor, lateral incisor, canine, first molar, second molar. And in permanent dentition, the human dentition have, let's see, here is a good concept over here. Behind central incisor is coming. Behind lateral incisor is coming. Behind canine, canine is coming. But behind first molar, what is coming? First premolar. What is coming? First premolar. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes.
Can you see? Behind first molar. You can check in your mouth. You can check in your mouth. Behind, you can say, after canine, your premolar is there, not molar. But in, you can say, primary dentition, behind canine, molar is there. Agreed, everyone?
Yes.
No issues. Behind second molar, second premolar is there. And after that, three molars are there. The third molar is known as wisdom teeth because it is coming at the age of 16 to 18 years. Because of that only, it is known as wisdom teeth because it is coming at a good age. Till that time, we become somewhat wise, you know. Agreed? Tell me, dear. So, what is the dental formula that is there? In case of deciduous dentition, there are two incisors. We are going to write two over here. One canine is there. Zero premolar is there, so zero. And two molar is there. So 2102 and 2102 is the dental formula of deciduous dentition. How we are going to calculate? Let's see. Let's see. Do you people know how we are calculating? We are calculating from the midline. I'm going to put this diagram over here. Leave it. Can you people see over here? 1-1 and 2-1 is written.
Yes, sir.
Yes, those are central incisors. So from where we are going to calculate? We are going to calculate from between the central incisor. So you can see over here, central incisor, lateral incisor. Two incisors are there in your mouth. One canine is there. Two premolars are there and three molars are there. Usually we write maxillary upon mandibular of one side. Half is there. So how many there are there? You can say teeth are there in this half. Eight, total 16, and 16 this side. So total teeth will be there. In the human permanent dentition is
32.
Agrees? Everyone? And how many teeth are there in the deciduous dentition? 2102. 5. 10 on half side, then 10 on another side. Total will be? 20, yes or no? No issues? Will you be able to differentiate between deciduous dentition and permanent dentition? Tell me, dear. Tell me. Say yes or no, please. Quickly.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So this is the dental formula for permanent teeth. Now, one question is there. What all teeth are there which originate only once, and what all teeth are there that originate twice in the life? You see, central incisor, lateral incisor, canine, first molar and second molar. These five tooth on one side and five tooth on the lower side, maxillary side, mandibular side. Two sides are there, na? So how many teeth are going to be there only once in the life? Two premolar and third molar. So three. How many of them are there which originate only once? 12. Your mouth is divided into four quadrants. Quadrant, you people know, divided into four parts. In each quadrant, these teeth are there. Yes or no?
So there are three premolars.
Three premolars, only two are there, not here. First and second.
So then why have you written 3 into 4?
3 into 4, because two over here, premolars, and one is third molar. So two premolar and one third molar. How many will be there?
3, sir.
In one quadrant. And how many quadrants are there in your mouth?
4, sir.
Understood, everyone?
No.
Any doubt in this?
No, sir.
The rest of the teeth originate twice in the life. They are known as diphyodont. Agreed, everyone? Do you people have any problem with this? Now, one thing is number of root. Only remember the numbers. Only remember the number. Do not go into this buccal and mesial aspect. Not required at all. Maxillary molar having how many roots? 3 roots. Maxillary molar having how many roots? How many roots are there for maxillary molar? Tell me, dear.
3.
Only maxillary molar having 3 roots. Mandibular molar having 2 roots. Maxillary premolar having 2 roots. Rest all teeth are there which is having only 1 root. Please listen to my words. I told maxillary molar having how many roots?
3.
Mandibular molar and maxillary premolar, how many roots are there?
Sir, Maxillary mandible, is 3 and mandibular.
Mandibular. No, mandibular molar and maxillary premolar. First, you can say first class is maxillary molar. How many roots are there? Maxillary molars. How many roots are there here? Three. Mandibular molar and maxillary premolar. How many roots are there?
Two, sir.
Two. Rest all the teeth have been? Only one root. Somebody will ask you, mandibular premolar, how many roots are there?
One, sir.
One. Everyone, please write this one in your notebook. Maxillary molar. Maxillary is the upper jaw. Yes or no? Maxilla is upper jaw, no?
Yes, sir.
And mandible is the lower jaw. So maxillary molar having how many roots?
Three, sir.
Mandibular molar and maxillary mandibular molar and maxillary premolar having how many roots?
Two, sir.
Two. And rest all the teeth having?
One.
That's all. Agreed?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So mandibular, maxillary molar, all of them, right, have three roots and not only one?
See, actually the thing that is there, na? Third molar having variable anatomy, but you people have to consider three roots only because it is the part of dentistry, not 11th or 12th.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you have to consider maxillary molar, three roots. That's all. These things I have written in the, you can say, notes, so that you people can refer to it whenever some questions are asked in the book. Do not try to mug it up because it is going to make, you can say, it is going to overburden you people. Okay. After NCRT, just read till here. Okay. If sometime you will see a question, you can see a bit. That's all. Not required. It is extra. Now I will be talking about caries. Caries, cavitation in your teeth. Yes or no? Do you people know that? Caries? Anybody having cavity in the, you can say, in the oral cavity? Nobody have? Do you know why enamel is that tough? Why enamel is that tough? Why it is not soft? Because enamel having inorganic component, a stone-like thing. It is the salt of calcium. And that also 90%. Yes or no? Only about 10% is the organic component. Yes or no? Only about 10% is the organic component.
Yes, sir.
Whenever you are going to eat chocolates, that sugar will be converted into lactic acid by bacteria. Lactobacillus and all, it is there in the oral cavity also. It is going to decrease the pH. And whenever, you must have read in animal tissue. Have you people read decalcified bone?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Dear, when we are going to put a bone into HCl, do you know what happens? The inorganic component starts leaching out. This is known as leaching, and bone becomes soft. Whenever the pH will be low, na, inorganic component will start coming out of the mouth. Now you see the component, which is 90% and tooth is strong because of that only. What do you think? What should happen in this case? What should happen in this case?
So the inner layers are exposed.
Yes, cavity will be formed. That is going to be known as caries. Pyria is infected gums and tooth socket. The next thing that you people need to know about tongue. What is there? It is a voluntary muscular organ of gustation. Gustation means taste sensation. What? Taste sensation. Tongue is voluntary muscular organ of gustation. Everyone agrees to this. Voluntary means it is according to your will. You want to move it, you can move it. Yes or no?
Yes or no?
It also helps in speech and mastication. There are three functions that is there for your tongue. Yes or no? The lateral view. We are going to see it from the side. It looks like this. There is a bone known as hyoid bone in the neck region only. To this only, tongue is attached. Agreed. To this only, tongue is attached. Everyone. Tongue is attached to hyoid bone only. Now, this is your floor of the mouth. And tongue is attached to floor of the mouth with the help of a structure known as lingual frenulum. What? Lingual frenulum. See over here. Can you people observe this kind of a structure in your oral cavity?
Yes, sir.
You people can observe, na? It is known as lingual frenulum. What? Lingual frenulum. So, the structure that attaches tongue to the floor of the mouth is known as what? Frenulum. Agreed? Tell me, dear. Say, now, have you seen this structure?
Sir?
Yes, tell me, dear.
Sir, can you repeat the function of lingual frenulum?
It is, what is there? It is going to stabilize your tongue inside the oral cavity. Okay? And it attaches tongue to the floor of the mouth. This is floor of your mouth. See over here? This is floor of your mouth. It is attaching the tongue to the floor of the mouth. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Frenulum. Yes or no? Can you people observe this structure in your oral cavity? Attaching your lips to gums?
Yes, sir.
Check it now. Dear, this is known as frenum. So see the difference between the spelling. One is frenulum and one is frenum. Agreed? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Everyone.
Yes, sir.
Now, let's see over here. Do you people know? Imagine this is an earthworm. You people have seen earthworm, no?
Yes,
you
sir.
People have seen earthworm, no? So, you can say the side which is in the direction of movement. This is known as anterior. This is known as posterior. The side which is, you can say, facing the air, it is dorsal, and the side which is facing the ground, known as ventral. But what happened in the case of human? Human stood up like this. Newman stood up like this. Like this. Yes or no? This is head. This is. If you consider this situation in human, you know, this surface is going to be anterior. Or rather ventral or dorsal. Let's see. See over here. This is the dorsal surface, no? Where spine is there. I think I have not. I am not able to make you people understand. See over here. See this diagram. Correlate this diagram. Earthworm there, like this. It was anterior, it was posterior, it was dorsal, it was ventral. Now, it got, you can say, stood up like this. Next, you can say, over here, one important thing that this dorsal is the extension of, just forget it, just forget everything. You people can see, hair is there on your head. Hair is there, no?
Yes, sir.
Do you know what is that? That can be considered as dorsal surface also. Okay, because you extend a bit, the hair will be there on the dorsal side. Okay, what I want to tell you people over here, tongue having two surfaces. Let's see, tongue having two surfaces. This surface that you people can see, can you people imagine this thing?
Yes, sir.
See over here. This surface is dorsal, you can say dorsal surface of the tongue. Okay? And tongue having ventral surface also. The surface present over here, you see, where frenulum is attached, what is that? Ventral surface. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Tongue having two surfaces. One is dorsal. The dorsal surface is upper one. Okay, that you people can easily see. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And the surface on which frenulum is there, that surface is what?
Ventral surface.
Ventral surface. So I have read the lateral view of the tongue. Now we are going to read dorsal view of the tongue. Dorsal view. The dorsal surface. You see, there is a small line of depression that is known as sulcus. Okay. Not very deep. It is going to, you can say, divide. Known as sulcus terminalis. It is going to divide the tongue into posterior one third and anterior two third part. Yes or no? The sulcus terminalis is going to divide your tongue into two parts. Tell me. Tell me, dear.
Yes, sir.
Everyone, the anterior two-third part is known as oral part, and the posterior one-third part is known as pharyngeal part. Agreed? Which is going to divide it? Sulcus terminalis. Everyone, now, one important thing. Your tongue is going to have papilla. What? Papilla. And the papilla is going to contain taste bud. Papilla is going to contain taste bud. And that act like chemoreceptor. Tell me, dear, one important thing. What do you people understand by the word receptor? What do you people understand? You people keep on hearing, na? Thermoreceptor. Okay, mechanoreceptor, chemoreceptor. Have you heard these words earlier?
Yes, sir.
What do you think? What is receptor? Sorry, what is receptor?
Sir, they pick up stimuli and send it to the brain to generate a response to it.
Yes, something like that only. Anybody else want to discuss or elaborate a bit more? Anybody of you want to discuss a bit more? Tell me, dear. Shreyas, Sri Gauri, Pooja, anybody? Have you heard this word earlier? Transducer. Have you heard this word earlier? The transducer.
No, sir.
See, it is a word that is going to be discussed in physics only. It converts one form of energy into another form of energy. You people must have read neurons in 10th or 9th in the earlier class, neurons. And you must have read nerve conduction also. On neurons, in which form impulse, you can say, is going to go or travel? In which energy form? Is it electrical energy? Is it electrical energy? Yes. Everyone, please discuss with me. Getting my point? This is the most advanced science on the earth. You cannot mug up all the time. Try to understand these things, dear. So, what is there in your food? Is it chemical energy?
Yes, sir.
And if that has to go to brain, that should be converted into which form?
Electrical impulses.
Tell me. Electrical impulses. That means something is there which is converting the chemical energy into electrical energy, no?
Yes, sir.
So, receptor is what? Converting one form of energy into another form. And the chemoreceptor is what? Which is converting the chemical energy into the electrical energy. Yes or no? Have you heard mechanism of vision, retina?
Yes, sir.
In that, the light energy are being converted into electrical energy. That is why cells present in the retina is known as photoreceptor. Photoreceptor, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Have you heard about organ of Corti in the ear?
Yes, sir.
At that place, mechanical rubbing is there. Hair cells are going to rub. Means at that place, in the organ of Corti, mechanical energy is going to be converted into electrical energy. Yes or no? So, mechanoreceptor word is used over there. So, on tongue, taste buds are there. Taste buds act as chemoreceptors. Now, what is the meaning of chemoreceptor? It is converting chemical energy into electrical energy. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
No issues? Let's see. Chemical will come in your oral cavity. It will go inside the test pore. And here, receptors are present. It will generate action potential. Later on, we will understand this thing. And that action potential will be going through the neurons to brain. Everyone, so remember this thing. Papilla contains taste bud. This is an important line. They will try to confuse this thing by just, you can say, changing the position of papilla and taste bud. They will tell you taste bud contains papilla. And you will think it might be correct. But it is not like that. Papilla contains taste bud. What all kind of papillas are there? See, just in front of sulcus terminalis, this papilla is there. This papilla is known as circumvallate papilla. Which papilla? Circumvallate papilla. Then, here, leaf-like papillas are there, known as foliate papilla. What? foliate papilla, then filiform papilla, then fungiform papilla. One important question that will be asked: filiform is the smallest papilla, most abundant, and it do not contain any taste bud. It do not contain any taste bud. Yes or no? Yes or no? Tell me, dear. How many types of papillas are there on the dorsal surface of the tongue?
Four, sir.
Four. See over here. Circumvallate, foliate. Foliate is not working in case of human. Foliate is not going to work in case of human. Agreed, dear?
Yes, sir.
Everyone. And even filiform papilla do not have taste buds. So, if you will see over here, the filiform papilla as well as foliate papilla do not have any role in case of taste as far as human is concerned. Yes or no? Everyone. So, your tongue is divided into posterior 1/3 and anterior 2/3. Agree with that point? Here? Everyone, agree with that point?
Yes, sir.
Yes. No issues? Now, do you people know about cranial nerves and spinal nerves?
Yes, sir.
How many pairs of cranial nerves are there in your body?
12, sir.
12 pairs. In that, taste sensation is taken away by 7th cranial nerve from anterior 2/3 part and 9th cranial nerve from posterior 1/3 part. So from the tongue, how many nerves are responsible to take away the sensation? You can say taste sensation. How many nerves are responsible to take away the taste sensation in the tongue?
Two, sir.
Two are there. From anterior 2/3, which nerve is, you can say, involved? 7th cranial nerve, that is facial. And from posterior 1/3, which nerve is there? Glossopharyngeal, 9th cranial nerve. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, tongue movement is caused by tongue movement. See, there are two kinds of function. One is motor function. By that, your muscle is going to move. And one is sensory function. By that, some sensation will be taken to brain. So, tongue movement is going to be caused by hypoglossal nerve. That is your 12th cranial nerve. Yes or no? So, how many nerves are, you can say, associated with function of tongue?
Three, sir.
Three. Tongue movement is going to be caused by hypoglossal nerve. Yes or no? Everyone, if I will talk about taste area of the tongue, sweet, salt, sour, and bitter over here. And you are going to eat chili, na? That is not actually the taste sensation. It is the pain sensation. Okay? No issues? Chili is going to have pain sensation that we are going to feel. Now, you can ask me, sir, why it is so specific, sweet, salt, sour, and bitter. You can ask me what I have told. If chemical will come, it will bind to its receptor. Yes or no? It is going to bind to its receptor now, over here, in the gustatory receptor cells. Some chemical are there that is going to bind to receptor now. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Everyone. It is going to bind. Yes. So if it is going to bind to receptor, so if receptor is a specific, like this receptor is there for sweet. In that case, which can stimulate these cells? Only sweet can stimulate, no? If this receptor is there for sweet, in that case, which substance is going to stimulate these cells?
Sweet, sir.
Sweet only. So these areas are divided because of this receptor. Like in this area, the you can say the taste bud having receptor for sweet. In this area, it is there for salt. In this area, it is there for sour. And in this area, it is there for bitter. Yes or no? Everyone, do you people have any doubt in this tongue area, tongue part? Tongue part?
Sir?
Yes, tell me, dear.
Sir, if the receptors of tasting such tastes are so specific, so then yes. Whenever we eat something which has a particular taste, even though we don't really put it in the place where the receptors are, we still get the taste.
See, the thing that is there, na? First thing, the chemical that is present on your tongue, it diffuses from one area to another area. This is one thing. Okay, it is not going to be localized or some boundary is there. It cannot go in some other area. It is not like that, no?
Yes, sir.
You can say, do your tongue is going to have boundary walls? It is not there, no?
Yes, sir.
It is not there. First thing. Second thing, you can say major taste buds for that thing is there in that area. Okay. You can say some taste buds are there in any area of the tongue. Okay. First, you can say your answer is there. Your question is there and my answer is the first point that chemical is not going to be localized in one area. It is going to be diffuse all throughout the tongue. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. And second thing, there may be some receptors for that particular taste also. Minor, you can say, stimulation can be there in any area. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Majorly, it will be localized to one particular area. Now, tonsils. What are tonsils? Tell me, dear. Have you people heard about tonsils?
Yes, sir.
You keep on hearing, na? Tonsillitis is there. So tonsils are lymphatic tissue of pharynx. What is the function of lymphatic tissue? They store lymphocytes. They store lymphocytes. Agreed? They store lymphocyte, everyone. And what is the function of lymphocyte, dear? They are going to neutralize any bacteria or any pathogen that is present in your or that is trying to come inside your body. Yes or no? That is the function of lymphatic tissue. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Everyone. That lymphatic tissue, which is present in the form of present in the pharynx, they are present in a circle. Pharynx, this is the pharyngeal tonsil. You people know this middle ear is going to open into pharynx with the help of eustachian tube. Your pharynx and middle ear is going to have one connection that is known as eustachian tube. Yes or no? Everyone. So the tonsils present around eustachian tube is known as tubal tonsil. A bit lower over here, palatine tonsil. It is present in the palate and in the lower area, it is known as lingual tonsil. So, in the simplest of word, I will say the tonsils of pharynx or lymphatic tissue of pharynx actually are present in the form of a ring. If you will draw this thing, it is going to form a ring. That is known as Waldeyer's ring. What is Waldeyer's ring? Tell me, dear. What is Waldeyer's ring?
Sir, the tonsils are
it represents a imaginary line on which all the tonsils are present. Agreed? Everyone? No issues? Till now? No issues till now? Tell me, dear. Shreyas, you are not speaking even, you can say now.
Sir, no issues.
Got it?
Yes.
Pooja? Dev?
Yes, sir.
Got sir. It now? Yes. Tell me, Shreyas.
Sir, just a request. When there's a lot of notes to write, sir, could you just pause on it and explain a little?
Yes. Whenever you like, na, you stop me. Okay, you feel like that, you just stop me. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
And I'm going to send you all these notes again. You can say also. It will be there. Gaurav sir is going to give you. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Just after the class, you will get the notes. You will get the assignment. Okay, read your NCRT very carefully. And whenever you feel like that, you just say, sir, let me copy. No problem in that, dear. Okay? Write it down. We have 3 hours class now.
Yes.
You people will be done. Please tell me once you are done. Done, everyone. So, do we take 10 minutes break?
Just
now only. We will be joining at 5:45. Agreed, everyone.
So can we have a 15-minute break?
Okay, no issues. No issues. We will be joining at 5:50. Okay. 5:50.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Yes, everyone. I'm back. Let's see. We were discussed till World Air 3. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, the esophagus. The story behind esophagus is a bit complex. Actually, what happens? The upper, if you divide esophagus into three equal parts, upper one third is voluntary in nature, contains a skeletal muscle. Lower one third is completely involuntary, contains a smooth muscle. In between mixing is there. As you will go down, voluntary fiber will decrease and involuntary fibers will increase. Yes or no? We consider upper one third of esophagus as voluntary and lower one third, sorry, two third as involuntary. Everyone agree to this? Agree to this? Tell me, dear.
Yes, sir.
Everyone? Now, in esophagus, successive contraction of a cycle of successive contraction and relaxation is going on, which is known as peristaltic movement. Later on, we will see the mechanism also. We will be talking about the next thing, that is stomach. Your stomach is going to be divided into four parts. One is cardiac part. Another is, fundus part. Then comes body and pyloric. How many parts are there? I think some of you were asking about parts of stomach earlier. Whose question was that? Who have asked this?
I asked.
Dev, yes. You got? How many parts are there? Four. Let's see. This is the opening of gastroesophageal sphincter. Above this opening, the part of stomach is going to be known as fundus. Going to be known as fundus. Yes or no, everyone? Sorry. See, this esophagus is going to open into this part. This part of stomach is known as cardiac part. Cardiac part. So there is a question. See this question. Esophagus opens into which part of a stomach? What will you say, dear?
Cardiac part.
Cardiac part or pyloric part? Body or fundus? Cardiac part. Now you see, can I say this gastroesophageal sphincter is present at the junction of esophagus and cardiac part of stomach? Hence, this stomach is also known as this this sphincter is also known as cardiac sphincter. Agreed? Now you people understood why gastroesophageal sphincter is known as cardiac sphincter. Tell me, dear. Agreed, everyone? Another name of GE sphincter?
It's a cardiac sphincter.
Agreed? So if you are going to see this, don't hesitate. Let's see. This main part of the stomach from here to here. This is known as body of a stomach. And the last part, which got narrowed down, is known as pyloric part. Yes or no? So how many parts are there for a stomach? Four parts: cardiac, fundus, body, and pyloric. Please let me know in which part esophagus is going to open. Please repeat.
Cardiac.
Yes. Now, you people can see, this is the greater curvature of a stomach. This is the greater curvature of a stomach, and this is the lesser curvature of a stomach. Greater curvature, lesser curvature. Agreed? Lesser curvature. Now, you see, all your organ is going to be wrapped around by peritoneum and attached to the body wall. That peritoneum having different name in the different part of your GIT. In a stomach, it is known as omentum. Omentum is wrapping the stomach all around and attaching it to the body wall. So the omentum present towards the greater curvature is known as greater omentum, and the omentum present towards the lesser curvature is known as lesser omentum. Everyone agree to this?
Yes, sir.
Agree to this? No issues? Greater omentum and lesser omentum, that is there. Now you just see one thing that I want to tell you all. The difference between these two diseases, please read it and try to understand on your own for a minute. After that, I will start explaining. You will get it. Done, everyone? Everyone, let's see. One is gastric regurgitation. Have you heard about this thing? After eating too much, sometimes you feel something that is very, you can say, bitter in taste coming inside mouth. Have you felt that thing? Have you people practical knowledge of this thing, gastric regurgitation?
Yes, sir.
At times it happens. We have a capacity of eating 3 breads. We have taken 5 instead. What will happen? It will be overfilled and this sphincter will not close properly. If gastroesophageal sphincter will not close properly, what will happen? The food will go inside esophagus from the stomach. Esophagus from stomach. Yes or no? Tell me. Gastric regurgitation. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Tell me. No issues?
Yes, sir.
Let's see. Gastric regurgitation is there, which is going to happen in the case when the cardiac sphincter or gastroesophageal sphincter is not closing properly. In that case, content of stomach is moving to esophagus and then into oral cavity. Yes or no? The second condition is ecclesia cardia. What? Ecclesia cardia. Try to understand. The bolus is trying to come down. Bolus is trying to come down. Let's see. The bolus is trying to come down. Let's see. The sphincter has not opened now. Will this bolus be able to go into stomach? If the cardiac sphincter is not opening, in that case, will the bolus be, you can say, will be able to go to stomach or not? Tell me.
No, sir.
Agreed. In that case, that food will remain inside your stomach, na? You can say esophagus, na? If cardiac sphincter will not open, in that case, food will be trapped inside esophagus, na? Say yes or no. If this sphincter is not able to open, food will be there in the esophagus, na?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, Tirthana, Pooja.
Yes, sir.
Tirthana, are you able to hear me? No? Am I audible to everyone now?
Yes, sir.
Yes. See over here. What I want to tell you all. Gastric regurgitation and ecclesia cardia are two diseases that is, you can say, related to gastroesophageal sphincter. Having doubt? Any doubt in this? Few general points about alimentary canal. It is the widest part of alimentary canal, contains finger-like projection known as gastric rugi. It helps in mechanical crushing of the food during churning movement. It stores food for 4 to 5 hours. Food mixed with gastric juice is known as chyme. Yes or no? These are the general points that you people need to know. About gastric rugi, I am going to tell you few things. One place where mechanical crushing is taking place is the mouth, oral cavity, by teeth. And another place inside the stomach, by which structure? What is the role of gastric rugi in that? Mechanical crushing of food, yes or no? Or yes or no? Please tell me, dear.
Yes.
Agreed, everyone? No doubt in that?
Mm-hmm.
Now, this part of alimentary canal is over. See, this part is over. I am going to enter this part now. Can you see duodenum, pancreas and all?
Yes.
See over here. I'm going to enter over there. Let's see. Here, this is duodenum. Anybody having doubt?
No, sir.
This is your liver. There are two lobes that your liver is going to have. This is your gallbladder. Any doubt in this? See over here, one duct is arising from gallbladder. What is the duct? Means pipe. I have already told you people. Ducts means pipe. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Here is cystic duct. Cystic duct. Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Cystic duct is the duct of gallbladder. Yes or no? Cystic duct is the duct of gallbladder. You see, hepatic word is used for liver. One pipe is coming from this way, this lobe. Another is from this lobe. They are going to form a hepatic duct. This is hepatic duct. Yes or no? Duct originating from liver. The duct of liver is known as what? Duct of liver is known as hepatic duct. Now try to understand my point here. cystic duct and hepatic duct. They have joined to form one duct known as
common bile duct.
Common bile duct, yes or no, everyone? Common bile duct, everyone? Agreed?
Sir, just a minute before explaining, could you give us 2 minutes to copy the diagram?
Yes, please. Copy it. Done? Are you done, dear?
So we are leaving.
Just a minute, sir.
No issues. Please inform. Thank you.
Sir?
Yes.
So what have you written like to the right below part of the hepatopancreatic duct?
Pancreatic duct? Duct of Wirsung. W-I-R-S-U-N-G. Wirsung.
And what is the ampoule of water?
Ampoule of water. Not water, water. W-V-A.
So what is the specter of something right next to the cystic duct?
That we are going to discuss. Let me discuss first. I am going to give you time to copy.
Yes, sir. But what is the spelling of the thing?
ODI. O-double-D-I. Sphincter of ODI, sphincter of Boyden. Done. Let's see. First thing I like to discuss, the hepatic duct is going to combine to cystic duct to form common bile duct. How the common bile duct is formed? Union of cystic duct with hepatic duct. Agreed? Cystic duct is the duct of gallbladder and hepatic duct is the duct of liver. Everyone? Tell me, dear. Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. This is your main pancreatic duct. Pancreas having two ducts. One is the main one. The main pancreatic duct is known as duct of Wirsung. W-I-R-S-U-N-G. Wirsung. Yes or no? You see, this common bile duct is going to join the main pancreatic duct. Yes or no? To form a common duct that is known as hepatopancreatic duct. How it is formed? How the hepatopancreatic duct is formed? It is formed by the union of common bile duct and main pancreatic duct. Yes or no? Tell me. It is formed by the union of common bile duct and main pancreatic duct. Yes or no? The hepatopancreatic duct. Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Everyone, do you people have any doubt in this? Now you see, this ampulla, the word ampulla means dilated part. What? Dilated part. Agreed? Let's see. This hepatopancreatic duct become dilated to form what? Ampulla of water. Ampulla of water. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Ampulla of water. So, ampulla of water is going to open into the duodenum and it is guarded by ampulla of water is nothing but the dilated part of hepatopancreatic duct only. And a sphincter of ODI is going to guard the opening of hepatopancreatic duct into duodenum. Yes or no? Tell me that. Yes or no?
Mm-hmm.
Everyone. Now, one is a sphincter of Boyden. A sphincter of Boyden. You see where it is present. Is it guarding the opening of common bile duct into pancreatic duct? Is it guarding the opening of common bile duct into main pancreatic duct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? So see over here, what happens? Bile is produced inside liver. It is produced inside liver. And when we are not eating anything, sorry. When we are not eating anything, in that case, what happens? this sphincter of Bowden is closed, means bile cannot go this way. So bile will come to gallbladder. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? When you are not eating, this is closed. Here it is closed. In that case, what will happen? The bile will come to gallbladder, where it is stored and concentrated. What is the function of gallbladder? To store and concentrate the bile. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And one thing, duodenum is C-shaped. At places, U-shaped is also written. But if you have to choose between them, C-shaped is the most correct answer. So, liver, from liver, which duct is originating there? Hepatic duct. And from gallbladder, which duct is there?
Cystic duct.
Cystic duct. They combine to form?
Common bile duct.
Common bile duct. And from there, what is going to? It is going to combine to which duct?
Duct of?
It will lead to a dilated part known as?
Ampulla of Vater.
Ampulla of Vater is going to open into?
Duodenum.
Yeah.
And which sphincter is there in place?
Sphincter of Oddi.
A sphincter of Oddi. And a sphincter of Bowden is going to go guard the opening of common bile duct into pancreatic duct. Do you people agree with all these things that is written over here?
Yes, sir.
Anybody having doubt? I have taken one more photograph from a good book, that is Dotra, and I have placed it over here so that you people can feel it a bit. Here, falciform ligament. Falciform ligament. It is going to connect two lobes of liver. Yes or no? Yes or no? It connects two lobe of. It connects two lobes of liver. Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? Do you people have any doubt in this segment? This segment is really very important. If you have, you can ask me. If you have something to copy, you can copy and please inform. Once you are done, please let me know.
Sir, could you show the hepatopancreatic duct in the picture?
Once common bile duct is going to join the main pancreatic duct, this part will be known as hepatopancreatic duct. Yes or no? This
yes,
part.
Sir.
Agreed, everyone? Yes. You want to copy anything? You can copy. That is not a problem. You can see it over here also. You can see it over here also. This diagram also. See this thing.
John?
Bilkul.
Done, everyone?
Done, sir.
Yes. One another thing that is there. Can you see there is one small extra pipe is there in pancreas? This one. Can you see apart from all these things? That is accessory pancreatic duct known as duct of Santorini. Known as duct of Santorini. It is not going to open into anything, directly opening into duodenum. Okay? No issues? Main pancreatic duct is known as duct of Wirson. The accessory one is known as duct of Santorini. Yes or no? Done? Everyone? Any doubt in this? Any doubt in this? Please tell me. No? Now, we are moving to intestine. Intestine. It is going to be divided into two parts, a small and a large intestine. A small intestine because diameter is smaller, and large intestine because diameter is larger. Yes or no? A small intestine because intestine is smaller. Large intestine because intestine is larger. Agree to my points. Tell me. The small intestine is 4.5 to 6 meters in length. Large intestine is around 1.5 meters in length. Yes or no? If you will see this thing, let's see. Duodenum is the smallest, only 25 centimeters, and ileum is the longest, which is the 3.5 meters. Jejunum is intermediate, 2.5 meters. Why the name jejunum is given? Jejunum means an empty space. During postmortem, it looks like it is empty. During postmortem, jejunum is found to be empty. Yes or no, everyone? I will tell you the reason later on. So duodenum, jejunum, ileum is the part of a small intestine. Cecum, colon, and rectum is the part of large intestine. Colon, ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, and sigmoid colon. Anybody having doubt in this?
No, sir. Just a minute, sir.
Yes. Everyone done?
Just a second, sir.
Yes.
Done.
Now, one thing I will like to tell you all here, the large intestine. Its surface is not smooth, rather it is in the form of pouches. Yes or no? Yes or no? These pouches are there, no? Do you know what are they? They are known as ostra. Okay, pouch-like structure present in large intestine is known as what? Ostra. Agreed, everyone? And you people can see over here, there are three. One, two, three. Three longitudinal band of muscle fibers a smooth muscle is there, this one. Can you people observe this thing? Can you observe?
Yes, sir.
In the middle, they are a smooth muscle, three. And is it along the length or not? Along the length or not?
Yes, sir.
If something is along the length, it is known as longitudinal. That is known as tinea coli. Tinea coli is a longitudinal band of muscles present over here. Yes or no? On large intestine. No issues in that? Everybody agree to this point, no? Hostra and tinea coli. Do you people understand? Do you people understand?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, let's see. Now, histology of alimentary canal. Histology of alimentary canal. What is that? Histology of alimentary canal. Tell me that. Tell me, dear. Histology means microscopic study of tissue. Okay, it is not, you can say, watching the tissue or observing it from the naked eye. You have to fix that and you have to see that under microscope so that you people can observe the cell. If you will go by that, the alimentary canal is going to have, four layers, serosa, muscularis, submucosa, and mucosa. Serosa, muscularis, submucosa, and mucosa. Everyone. Yes or no? See, this is the lumen where food is moving, and this is the outer part. Outer to inner. Outermost is? Outermost is? Serosa. Everyone. No issues? Tell me, dear. The outermost layer of alimentary canal is what? Serosa. If you will enter this, this is, and this one, these two layers are muscularis. The outer layer of muscularis is longitudinal and inner one is circular. Everyone? Everyone?
Yes.
No issues? Outer one is longitudinal and inner one is circular. Being longitudinal means, see over here, it should be along the length. See over here. It should be along the length. These muscle layers are along the length, like this. Like this. Agreed? If you are going to cut the cross section, you will be able to see only this view. If you are going to cut the cross section, you will be able to see only the top view. Yes or no? If you will see your pen from the top, how it looks like? Is it looking like long or circular? From the top. Your pen is there, no?
Circular.
You are writing from here. If you will see it from this view, any cylindrical thing, it is along the length. That means it is cylindrical. Yes or no? Any cylindrical thing is there. You are going to see this, that thing from here. It looks like what? Like this or not? Tell me, dear. Tell me. Say yes or no. Yes. So, in the cross section, the longitudinal is going to look like a circular one. Yes or no? Do not confuse. Because when you will forget, your concepts are going to take you out from that situation. Yes or no? See over here. This is which layer? See, we have interacted for, you can say, too many classes now. So you people have understood my way, how we are going to discuss. You people should, you can say, reply all the time. Okay, only 7-8 students are there. I don't think much noise is going to be there. So if you are getting, please let me know. Otherwise, I feel like whether have you got or not. So if something is longitudinal, if you will see it from here, it look like it is circular. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. And see cap or your of your pen. This is cap of your pen. See from this view. It is circular, na? If you will see it from here, it look like it is long. Like this. Yes or no? Cap of your pen, divide it into 2-3 parts. See over here. Divide that into 2-3 parts. Now, do it look like this one? Do it look like that only? Is it like that, na?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? So circular thing, if you are watching it from the top, from this area, it will look like it is long and something that is cylindrical. After cutting, you are going to see it from this. It will look like it is circular. So have you people understood why it is demarcated like this? The circular one is inner one and the longitudinal one is outer one. This is known as muscularis layer. Yes or no, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now, inner two muscularis, the submucosa is there and mucosa is going to be there, which is going to line the lumen. Now, the question is, which of the following layer of alimentary canal lines the lumen? What do you think? This question. What should be the answer? Is it mucosa?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, is it mucosa? Tell me, dear.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So these are the four layers. Mucosa having four, you can say three divisions. One is muscularis mucosa, lamina propria, and mucosa proper. Okay. Mucosa proper is the epithelial tissue. Have you heard epithelial tissue? What kind of epithelial tissue is there in the stomach and the esophagus and all? You people have heard, na? Simple squamous epithelium and all. Tell me, dear.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So epithelial tissue, how it is going to work? I have taken a diagram from a book of medical physiology, that is A.K. Jain. You people are going to read that in MBBS first year. Okay, this diagram is there. And this diagram is very informative. Okay, what have I told? How many layers are there in your GIT? From esophagus till rectum, how many layers are there? Tell me, dear. How many layers are there from esophagus till rectum? Please answer.
Sir, I didn't really get your question.
How many layers are there in your GIT starting from esophagus to rectum?
Four, sir.
And what all are there? Serosa? Yes or no?
Yes, sir. Muscularis, submucosa, and mucosa.
Yes. Now I am going to observe all these layers into different parts of your GIT. Okay, we will see all these layers in the esophagus, in the mucosa, duodenum, and jejunum and ileum. These three are there. These four are there, sorry. In the four parts, we will observe these things. Okay, see over here. Do you people know what is peritoneum? What is peritoneum? Do you people know? See, have you heard about ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm, all these things? No? See, there are three germ layers that is formed during embryonic stage. Outer one is ectoderm. Then comes mesoderm. Okay, three plates are there. And then comes endoderm. Yes or no, everyone? This is ectoderm. This is mesoderm. And this is endoderm. Yes or no? Tell me. Have you heard about all these things? Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
now
sir.
What happens? Now what happens, dear? There is a coelomic cavity that is going to develop. There is a cavity that is going to develop inside mesoderm. Yes or no? This cavity is known as what? Coelom. What is the definition of coelom? Body cavity lined by mesoderm. Can you see? Can you see? This side also mesoderm is there, and this side also is, you can say mesoderm is there. You cannot call coelom simply as body cavity, because in your oral cavity also, you can say mouth also, oral one cavity is there. Inside esophagus also, cavity is there. Inside the stomach, a cavity is there, but none of them are coelom. Yes or no? You people have done animal kingdom, no? Animal kingdom?
Yes.
What is the definition of coelom? Body cavity lined by mesoderm. Can you see? Here is a cavity, this one. This side and this side, both the side, it is lined by mesoderm. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? Now, this is going to be covered by a membrane. That membrane is known as peritoneum. Yes or no? Peritoneum. The inner one is going to be known as visceral peritoneum. And the outer one is known as parietal peritoneum. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. And extension of this only, like pericardium. Pericardium, you people have heard. The covering of heart, parietal pericardium and visceral pericardium, pericardial space. In earlier classes, you may have heard about that. Leave it. You people have heard about omentum, no? In a stomach?
Yes, sir.
Omentum is also extension of peritoneum only. Yes or no? So what have I told? Outer covering is greater omentum, means peritoneum is there. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Aren't you people getting it? Other people, Dev, Kirthana, Pooja, are you getting it or not?
Yes, sir.
See, what have I told? All your organs are going to be lined by peritoneum. And that peritoneum is only what? serosa. Serosa is a peritoneum only. Agreed? Now, we are going to go slightly at the neat level. Getting my point? Let's see. You can see in all the organs, outer covering is serosa. This is visceral peritoneum. I have told you people in this diagram, na? What is visceral peritoneum? Let's see. Let's see. This is the inner one. This peritoneum is what? Visceral peritoneum. Yes or no? Everyone. So what is serosa? It is a visceral peritoneum. So a stomach, duodenum, and jejunum, and ileum, even large intestine. Their outer covering is serosa, which is a visceral peritoneum. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Say yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now, in esophagus, visceral peritoneum is not there. Its outer covering is fibrous and it is known as tunica adventitia. Means if somebody will ask you in which part of GIT serosa is absent, what will you say?
It's esophagus.
It's esophagus. Yes or no? Then comes longitudinal muscle. Then comes circular muscle. In all the part, longitudinal and circular muscles are there. You see, what is there in a stomach? More strength is required. Some oblique muscle is also there. So, in a stomach, there is modification in the muscularis layer. Yes or no? Everyone, tell me, dear.
Yes, in
serosa, modification is there in the esophagus because in esophagus, serosa is absent. In a stomach, which part is showing modification? Tell me, dear. Muscularis. Why? One additional layer of oblique muscle is there. In other, like somebody will ask you, oblique muscle is present in. What will you say? Yes. Now, this is some mucosa. It is having blood vessel. It is having blood vessel. It is having nerves and all. This is blood vessel. This is nerve. With yellow color, we are going to demark. Now, can you observe anything in the submucosa of duodenum? Can you observe anything in the, you can say, submucosa of duodenum? Anything, please say.
So there's a gland.
Which? Brunner's gland. So if I will say Brunner's gland is situated in the submucosa of duodenum, is it all right?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to write a very important question. Brunner's gland is situated in the submucosa of what? Submucosa of what?
The duodenum.
Agreed, everyone. Agreed, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Brunner's gland is situated in the submucosa of duodenum. Now, I will be talking about mucosa. It is having muscularis mucosa, lamina propria, and mucosa proper. Let's see. This layer is muscularis mucosa, very thin and rudimentary in human, not functional. Then this part is lamina propria. Yes or no? And this part is mucosa, which is epithelial tissue. Yes or no? You people can observe over here in the, you can say, In the esophagus, it is non-keratinized, stratified squamous epithelium. Do you people have any problem in this? In esophagus, it is non-keratinized, stratified squamous epithelium. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. And in the stomach and intestine, it is simple columnar epithelium. In the small intestine, it is, and stomach, it is simple columnar epithelium. Till now, no issue is there. You can see a finger-like folding that is present in the stomach. What is this?
So, what is the column before the stomach indicating?
What is?
So, what's the column before stomach indicating?
Where? Here?
Oh, no, sir. I just wanted to know what was before the stomach. It's esophagus, sir. Got it.
Yes. Yes, now see. See over here, dear. What is this known as? This finger-like projection.
Gastric rugae?
Yes. And what is the function of gastric rugae? Mechanical mixing of food during churning movement of stomach. Churning movement is a typical movement of stomach. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
And one, this kind of projection in the small intestine, this is known as what? You people must have read columnar
villi, sir.
Simple columnar brush border epithelium. You should know difference between villi and microvilli. Are you clear in this?
So you're sending this as notes, right? All of this?
Yes, I will send. Yes, I will send. Yes. No issue in that. Let's see. This folding is your villi, na? Folding of mucosa. Now this mucosa is going to contain cells also, na? Cells are there? Columnar cells are there? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Can you see? One cell is this. You can say, observe this surface of this cell and this cell. What is the difference between these two? Can you see the surface of cell is also folded?
Yes, sir.
This is known as microvilli. What? This blue one is known as villi, and the folding of cell is known as microvilli. This kind of epithelium is known as simple columnar brush border epithelium. What do you think? What they are going to you? They are supposed to do? What they are supposed to do?
So increase surface area for absorption.
Area for absorption. Agreed, dear? Agreed, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now, everyone will see. See, this is the level of base of villi. This is known as base of villi. Can you see there is one depression that is present below the base of villi also? Base of villi, below the base of villi, depression is present, na? Over here? Tell me.
Yes.
This one, what is that known as? That is known as crypts of liver cone. What? Crypts of liver cone. Agreed, everyone? Yes. A depression present below base of villi is known as crypts of liver cone. Yes or no? Tell me that. Tell me that. Everyone. Aren't you people getting?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So I want to add one more point about Bruner's gland. It is present in the submucosa of duodenum and opens into which part? Do you people agree with me? Do you people agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Tell me, dear. Sir, now, do you? Yes, tell me.
Can you speak crypts of Leverkund?
Crypts of Leverkund. This is there. This part, see. This is base of villi. Villi's base is there. This is the base. Below the base, there is one depression present. That is known as crypts of Leverkund. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, now, do you people think that bacteria can go across your mucosa? Bacteria can go across your mucosa. Tell me that. If I am eating something, there are chances, like in food, bacteria is there, that bacteria can cross my oral mucosa and go into the blood. Chances are there or not? Chances are there or not?
Yes, sir.
It is there, no? So wherever mucosa is there, no? Wherever mucosa is there, below mucosa, there is lymphoid tissue. And I have told you people the function of lymphoid tissue while discussing tonsils. While discussing tonsils, yes or no? I have told you that, not here.
Yes, sir.
Everyone, I have told you that, na? Function of lymphoid tissue, bacteria will try to enter here. Below mucosa, there is a continuous structure, that is lymphoid tissue is present, which is going to attack the bacteria. Yes or no? That is known as mucosa associated lymphoid tissue. Wherever mucosa is present, below it, mucosa associated lymphoid tissue is present. Yes or no? In the oral cavity, in the esophagus, everywhere it is present. Yes or no? Below mucosa it is present, hence it is known as what? Mucosa associated lymphoid tissue. Agreed? Can you observe this gray one?
Yes, sir.
What happens? This malt, mucosa-associated lymphoid tissue, get aggregated in the ileum region. And this aggregation is known as what? What? Please say. Pears patches. What? Pears patches. What?
Pears patches.
So what are Pears patches? They are aggregation of lymphatic tissue in the ileum area. Agreed? They are aggregation of lymphatic tissue in the ileum area. Yes or no? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
So what is the definition of Pears patches? See, dear, these things are a bit important, okay? I have two options. You can teach you people very basic things and you people will understand everything. But if you have to learn things, you people should make one thing clear. After going from here, you just see that you do not understand, you get back to me. Getting my point? You get back to me. If you will have doubt, please say anybody over there. You say, Gaurav sir, he will convey it to me and I am going to clear that doubt. Getting my point?
Yes, sir.
If I am teaching you people, getting my point, in that case, no questions should be missed in the NEET examination from that part. Okay, that is my simple aim. Getting my point? So try to learn things logically. Human body is the most advanced machine on this earth. None of the engineer has made a more efficient machine, you can say, which is, you can say, more efficient than human body. And you cannot run a, you can say, most complex machine just by mugging it up. Try to understand things. Okay. So what is malt? What is the use of malt, or why malt is there? Because mucosa is there. If I am eating something, bacteria can go inside my blood. In that case, who are the soldiers of your blood? Lymphocytes and all are WBCs are there, na?
Yes, sir.
And they are stored. Lymphocyte, one of the WBC, is stored in the lymphoid tissue. So who will come out to fight?
So the lymphocytes.
So below mucosa, lymphoid tissue is needed. It is the 12th portion. And that is known as malt, mucosa-associated lymphoid tissue. Only that tissue got aggregated in the ileum region to form what? Stress?
Peyer's patches, sir.
Peyer's patches, Pooja. It will be Peyer's patches, yes or no? And the function of Peyer's patches will remain the same as that of lymphoid tissue. Yes or no? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Agreed? So, Peyer's patches is present in the lamina propria part of mucosa, because mucosa having three parts. Yes or no? Have you people understood definition of gastric, you can say gastric rogi, villi, microvilli, breast border, or simple columnar breast border epithelium, Peyer's patches, and all. Bruner's gland. Now you see one thing. I'm asking you people have to answer. Serosa is saying modification in which part? Serosa is showing modification in which part?
Esophagus.
Muscularis is showing modification in which part?
Stomach.
Yes. Duodenum is, submucosa is showing modification in which part?
Duodenum.
And mucosa is showing modification in almost all the parts. So is this line justified?
Yes, sir.
All the four layers show modification in the different part of elementary canal. And the second line that I have given you people, Bruner's gland is situated in the submucosa of duodenum and opens into crypts of liver cone. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, enteric nervous system. What is the meaning of enteron? Enteron. The word enteron is used for intestine or your GIT. Yes or no? You see, there are two. Plexus means a bunch. Plexus means a bunch. Yes or no? Bunch only. There are two plexuses that are there. One is submucosal or Meissner's plexus, and one is myenteric. See, my word is used, na? This word is used for muscle. What? Getting my mycium and all. Myometrium. So this is going to signify muscle only. Myenteric plexus or Orbach's plexus. Let's see. Can you see a red line between circular and longitudinal muscle? Can you see that? This line. Can you see that? Can you see that? Everyone, can you see this red line? Is it present between circular and longitudinal muscle? This is known as myenteric plexus inside the muscle, or orbex plexus. And can you see this line, blue one, between submucosa and muscularis layer? This is known as submucosal or Meissner's plexus. They are the local nerve supply of your GIT. Yes or no? They are the local blood supply of your GIT. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Everyone. So submucosal plexus is present between muscularis and submucosa, rather inside submucosa, and myenteric plexus is present between longitudinal and circular muscle. Yes or no? Tell me. Yes or no? Tell me, dear. Everyone, this is sensory in nature. It will take sensation to brain. And from there, secretion of GIT starts. For secretion of GIT, which one is required? And peristaltic movement is a muscular movement that is responsible for that. Myenteric plexus is, you can say, responsible. Yes or no? Everyone. What is the function of Meissner's plexus? What is the function of Meissner's plexus? Tell me, dear. What is the function of Meissner's plexus?
It controls the secretions in GIT.
Yes. And what is the function of myenteric plexus? They control, or orbex plexus, they control peristaltic movement. Yes or no? Everyone, do you people have any doubt?
No, sir.
No? You people can observe this thing also, and please observe and try to understand.
So,
see, yes, tell me, dear.
Sir, could you just show the previous flowchart again?
Yes, of course. Try to understand thing. Getting my point? If somebody having doubt, okay, from the next class onwards, if somebody having doubt, I will stay after the class, or I will join, you can say, previously. If you have doubt, please let us know. If you will say that, sir, we have doubt, I will be there anytime.
Done, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Let's see. Okay. See this also, you will get the, you can say, notes, and bye, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay.